Okay, hi Chris.
Hey, how are you doing?
There's something called Code in Place that you run, right?
Yes.
There are a lot of projects afterwards.
Yeah.
Did you see them before?
You know, I've seen some of them. There's about 10,000 students every Code in Place, so I don't always get to see all of them.
I've prepared for you a list of projects today.
Yeah.
For your React. I'm curious to see your reaction towards
it. I can't wait. This sounds like the best way to spend a morning.
Because this also reflects on you as well, if it's not good, right?
Well, I mean, I give all the credit to the students.
Okay. First project.
Okay, David Nguyen says, yep. I made this for Code in Place, run it. Okay, ooh, a velocity. I'm definitely going with 10. It wanted 1 to 20. Oh, look at that. Oh, that's awesome. That is not easy to do. David must have been thinking a lot. There was gravity. I'm not sure if there was friction. I love it. That is very thoughtful. I feel like that's a proof of concept that if he wanted to go make like a physics engine for a game, he's in a pretty good spot. I think I should try it again. I should try it with like 20. See if it was just a can thing. Oh man, look at that. It preserves the momentum and everything. I love it.
Do you think he could have done something even crazier?
Well, I noticed the little balls don't collide with each other. And actually, this is a small thing that's interesting. You know, if you want to know if two balls collide with each other, it's the easiest collision because you just need to check if the sum of their radiuses or the distance between them is smaller than the sum of their radiuses. Now, once you decide that two circles collide, figuring out how they should move next is a real interesting math challenge. Mm-hmm. And actually, that kind of speaks to, like, I was pretty good at math. I'm not, like, teach math at Stanford and I do, like, research in math. I think the critical part for me was projects like this. Mm-hmm. Like, I was trying to figure out how to do some, like, basics physics in code, and then all of a sudden it pushed me into, like, excitement about math that I never had before. That's so awesome. I hope David has that experience too. Whoa! Check that out! Beautiful. Oh, wait, this pattern in the background. I have an idea of how this was done. That is fantastic. So, okay, obviously it's showing a clock, and it seems like the clock might actually be showing the right time. Oh, but it's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What's that about? So this is, our hand seems to be pointing at the right place, but I'm so curious what those numbers are. Does it explain? But I must say, I'm also fascinated about this background pattern. I wonder if it's an image, but if this was created procedurally, which it could have been, that's beautiful. Like, I've seen incredible artwork made by code that I think was used to generate this.
It actually is a fractal.
Oh, it is a fractal. Yeah. Oh man, that's amazing. It's a beautiful fractal. In Stanford, we have like the first course of the CS major and the second course of the CS major. Like, I think this person's ready for that second course. To rock that second course.
Do you think it's kind of crazy how these are just basic graphic libraries provided by you?
Actually, this is intentionally done in Code in Place, so we give you very simple primitives, like here's how you draw a circle, here's how you draw a rectangle, here's how you can put a little bit of text, and then we make you take that to the next level. Obviously, there could be like a way you could have generated this with just a picture, but that wouldn't push you in the way that would allow you to flourish later. So with simple primitives, look at the beauty that was created. We live in a gorgeous world and there's brilliant students in it. I feel inspired. So initial velocity, 2, 5, 1, 2. Oh, really cool. You know, there is this really interesting research, you know what this makes me think about? There's this research that showed that when people learn to code, they start to do better in all their other subjects. Like, people got better at math, they got better at, like, reading and things that seem disparate. And I think, I always wonder why. It's an open question why. I think there's two hypotheses. One is, it just challenges your mind, and your mind just, like, gets better at problem solving. And then there's this other one that, like, I can imagine somebody sitting down and trying to do this as a physics problem, finding it really hard to understand everything that's going on. But this student leverages the power of computers, gets to visualize it, gets to test hypotheses and be much more in the experimental situation that physicists love to be in. And I think that might also be explaining this observation that people who learn to code do better in their other subjects. I could watch this all day.
Oh, wow. And it's also just like high school level physics, right? But then they translate it to something like that we feel is much more advanced.
Yeah, exactly. It's I must say though, in 2025, that ability to see how you can take simple concepts and make it into a higher order thing is one of the most important meta skills. This is fun. Wordle clone. Okay, how to play. Guess the word in 6 tries. Each guess. You know what? Well, I'm not the best in my family, but we play a lot of Wordle. Let's play. Enter a valid 5-letter word. Let's do heart, just for fun. Oh, fantastic. Look, they highlighted the keyboard. So I know that the A is right. Mouse, let's do it. We know it doesn't have an E though. Yeah. But now we have an M and we know where the A is. I'm not gonna embarrass myself with my Wordle skills in front of everybody. But you know, small notes, like we just gave them primitives, like how to press. We didn't give them buttons, but like the student had made working buttons from those primitives and then made working version of Wordle. That's cool. Isn't Wordle an interesting story too? Because it was like, I saw there's other spin-offs of on Wordle where you can do like, you know, we're going to try and predict different sequences of numbers. So I love this. Once you get to this ability, you can imagine like throw a little more creativity into this. Instead of recreating someone else's game, you'd be making a game that never existed before that maybe has a chance of taking the internet by storm. I wonder if they've copied the shareable link and shared it with a lot of friends. Ooh, play. Code in Place 2024. Code in Place is one of the most fun things I get to do. The name just makes me happy. Okay, the house uses two decks. Okay, are we going to be counting some cards? Dealer hits below 17 or at soft 17. Got it. Aces count 11 or 1 depending. So I guess I hit shuffle. Seems like my only choice. There it goes. The two decks look well represented. It looks like they've actually represented everything properly. Well, I should take some cards. I got a queen. Pretty queen and a two. I guess I gotta go for it, don't I? Do I go for the win underneath? I think I stand. 13. Ah! This is it. So I think this student owes me money. Oh no, I lost! Wait, how did I lose? Oh, that was 21. Yeah, was it 21? Yeah. Brutal.
Is that surprising for you to have animation inside of...
Yeah. Oh, I mean, like all those things, like the student has to like, think through from first principle. I love it. So I owe them money.
Yeah.
A fruit sorting game. Use the right and left arrows to guide the fruits to the correct side, avoiding rotten or bug-infested fruit. Okay, welcome. Whoa, what? Okay. Oh, orange. That's not an orange. That's a banana. Oh my god! Wow. Okay, I think I get it. Apple. Banana. Apple. I wonder if I should just be making oranges. Oranges. Okay, I got 20. That's not bad, but I feel like if I practice this, I'd get much better. That was really cool. So this seems original. So I guess there's a lot about this that seems cool. You know, it looks like everything was made from first principles. I like the... Are these things growing? They do look like they're growing. That seems like somebody was very clever about... I had a friend who I used to work with when I was learning to code, who now works for this company that makes a game called Civilization.
Oh.
Yeah. It was funny because I saw him learn how to program. And it started with games that looked like this. Like he was just making some little things. And then you know, obviously that's something that he fell in love with. But I feel in the world of computer games for a long time, it's the particular thought process they went to take something that looks really complicated, like a 3D game, but actually hit it from a low level approximation. Brilliant. I love it. Next up, Civilization. Man, after 6 weeks of coding, you know, I guess this is a interesting thing about Code in Place is that the majority of people, I think like 98%, start with zero coding experience before. That is really the students that we worked with. And if you're willing to put in the time, you can do a lot of amazing things. Now, it's not going to be the easiest thing, but it'll leave you as like a smarter, more skillful person. And the beautiful thing, like I can just see this. Like if a student can get to this point, they've gotten to that magical moment in programming where like, you have the ingredients, you have that foundation, and you can just start to like turn your creativity into real things. I like to think about it as like, when you're learning to program, the first thing you have to learn is like learn how a car works and how to drive a car. Mm. And after you've learned how to drive a car, then you're going on road trips. You're exploring the world and you get to go really far and do really wonderful things. These people know how to drive cars. Oh, yeah. They're ready for road trips. One of the most fun things is to learn new skills, like how to code. But I don't know if everybody knows this, but I think there's one thing even more fun, which is to teach, like to pass on this knowledge and see the aha moment in other people's lives. I guess that's why we do Code in Place. We're definitely not doing it for money, it's free. That was so fun, man. I want to do this again. You know what we should do? We should do Code in Place 2025. Like, okay. You know.
So can you give like a quick call to action for them?
Yeah, I would say this. Hey, you know, you have a wonderful potential. All of you guys, if you've never programmed before, this class is made for you. If you've done a little bit of programming, it could also be made for you, but like, you know, push your mind, learn new things, and learn how to turn just things that are in your head into code. It's a time where computers are more powerful than ever. Learn that language of computers so that you can create on order of magnitude more than you could before this class. Well, thanks so much for that. I really appreciate it.
Yeah, for sure.
Thank you.